like myself. I've been having strange dreams lately. But now you're here. And I'll make you feel right at home.
He is literally 100% manipulative. He leads you into this false sense of security, and he wants you to trust him because he wants to take advantage of it. From the surface, like especially in this first bit where he says, if dinner is what you want, then I can provide. Like in this, and I wanted this to come across in a seductive way while also masking this like burning rage inside that breaks through the suave nature of it. That was my clue to reveal he's not your friend. Here to use you. Like, that's the antithesis of what I want to be. And so, if I'm gonna make an opposite version of me, he's gonna be the fucking worst. He seems like someone you can trust. And he will manipulate you and take advantage of you and literally use you. And to me, that's terrifying.
Destroy mankind. see, I've been given a gift. Whatever I write happens, and Daniel was the perfect subject. He cooperated, unlike you. You see, cooperation is key. Working together and believing in one another, that's essential. That's the thing that you need to learn about this agreement that we have. So, what we're going to do is we are going to stay here, in this room, for however long it takes for you to learn to cooperate!
Alone and unsuspecting, a young boy finds himself transported into a dense, eerie forest. The lad's name? Ryan Tisdale. As the first page was ripped off the worn shed, Ryan could sense a cool breeze running up his legs. The presence around Ryan became more insidious with each page discovered. The end of this story was so close, it's as if it was right under his nose. Unbeknownst to Ryan, I had another trick up my sleeve. And it involved blunt force trauma.
are keeping an eye on things. You stopped paying attention.
how many band-aids, how much AIDS you have on you. I will eat you. I will eat all of you. Not you guys.
Dead. You're not, how could you be dead? I wouldn't have killed you. I didn't kill you. I mean, of course, I didn't kill anybody. It was all a joke. Of course, it was all a joke. Were you in on this? Did Damian put you up to this? Of course he did. Damian, where are you, you rapscallion? Where are you? Celine! Oh, it's time to come out now! Ah! Oh. Good, good. You're almost happy. Where is he? He took them from me. He took my friend from me. He took Celine. He took Damian. Where is he? Where is he? Detective! Are you hiding him from me? Get out of forever. Get out of my way. Detective! Better choose her next words carefully, Colonel. About that. And you, sir, are no friend of mine.
If we don't want to talk about friends, you murder!
I didn't kill anybody. This is madness.
Don't you want to talk about madness? Madness is stealing your best friend's wife. Madness is squeezing him for cash to fund your own sick sexual exploits with that very woman.
Shut up!
Madness is wanting the death of your childhood friend because you can't handle it.
Thank you.